class, I gave you the explanation of Noise Saves Away. And I hope you have read the story and understood the story properly. And I also told you to learn all the word meanings which is given. And today we will see the exercise which is given at the back of the chapter. So you all open page number 4. Okay. So we will start the explanation part. First is understanding the text, A part. So here match the words in A with the words in B to make complete sentences. So first one is Noi walked along the shore and, so you match it with the C, spotted something in the distance. I will write it here. A bulb matches with C. Two, Noi knew that it was not good for a whale to be out of the water for a long time because even it could not survive on land for long. So two matches with E. Third, he filled a bucket with water from the sea and poured it over the baby whale. A. Three matches with A. Fourth, after taking the baby whale back home, Noi filled the bathtub with cold water and put the whale inside. So B. Fourth one matches with B. Fifth, Noi and his father put the baby whale in a water boat and rowed out into the sea to put it back into waters. So it is F. Five matches with F. Sixth one, Noi knew it was the right thing to do, but it was hard for him to say goodbye to his friend. So it is 6. D. It matches with D. So 1 C, 2 E, 3 A, 4 B, 5 F and 6 D. Okay. Now children, next is question answer. So first I will tell you what kind of copy you have to make it. You have to make for both English 1 and English 2, you will make 2 lines copy as you make it for Hindi copy, no? The same copies, 2 line copies you will make for both English 1 and English 2. And you will write your date first, then you will put the heading of the chapter. You will write chapter 1, Noi Saves a Whale. And then you will start writing, first you will write question and below that you will write answers. And please children, write question answers in a very good handwriting. It should be neat and clean, and also be very, very careful about spellings. Don't make mistakes in spellings, children. So you have to copy the question answers very carefully, okay, without making any mistakes. So for question answers, I will give you PDF. You will get the question answers in PDF so that you can see and write. But now I will just discuss it orally so that you can understand. So first question is, in the morning, Noi went down to the beach. Why did Noi go down to the beach in the morning? Because he wanted to see what had been left behind by the storm that took place the night before. It must have been washed up because of the storm, Noi thought. What did Noi spot on the beach? How did it appear on the beach? So Noi spotted a baby whale on the beach, and the baby whale had been washed ashore because of the storm. Third question, with much difficulty he lifted the whale and put it in the cart. Why did Noi put the whale in the cart? So Noi put the whale in the cart because he wanted to take it home, as he knew that the whale would not be able to survive on land for long. Fourth, I've been so busy, Noi, I never realized that you were so lonely. Who said these words? Noi's father said these words. How did he realize that Noi was lonely? So Noi's father realized that Noi was lonely because, or when Noi told him that the baby whale was the only friend he had. Fifth question, we must take it back to the sea, to the place where it belongs. How did Noi and his father take the baby whale back to the place where it belonged? How did Noi feel at that time? So Noi and his father, they put the whale in a motorboat, and after rowing out into the sea, they put the whale back into the sea, and Noah felt very happy after putting the whale into the sea. So next, see when you can leave, enjoying the text also you can leave. Next we come to grammar and usage. Okay, so you will get these words: whale, stories, knowing. The words and colors are nouns. So children, you have already studied what are nouns. The name, the nouns are the names or the words that tells about person, place, animal or thing. Naming words are called nouns. Okay, so we have learned that a noun is the name of a person, place, animal or thing. It can be common noun when we talk about in general, any kind of person, place, animal, thing of the same kind, it is common noun. And proper noun, when we talk about any particular person, place, animal or thing, that is proper noun. This you have already studied. And singular, one, we call it singular, and when there are many, we call it plural. Okay, like one chalk, singular; many chalks, plural, right? So question is, underline the noun in these sentences. So first one, Padma is on the train to Thrissur now. So Padma is a name, particular name of a girl, it is a proper noun. Train is a common noun, and Thrissur is also a proper noun. Second, can you find the face of a clown in this picture? Now which you will underline? Face. Okay, face is a common noun. You just have to underline, don't mention it. Face, then clown, and picture. So I'll write it here. Second, you have to underline face, clown, picture. Okay, this you will underline. All are common nouns. Second, Kiran is going to Mumbai to play a cricket match. So Kiran, you underline Kiran is a proper noun. Then you can underline Mumbai. This is also proper noun. And third, you can underline cricket and also bat. Okay, this you will underline. We always go to Dr. Reena. This you underline. This is proper noun. Underline it. And she is an excellent doctor. Doctor, you can underline. This is a common noun. The animals are at the pool. So underline animals. This is also common noun. Pool. Pool is also a common noun. Water, day. They are also common noun. Water, day. Next one. Our cat, Roxy. Cat, you can underline. This is common noun, Roxy. This is proper noun. Has become friendly with our neighbor's parrot. So neighbor, you can underline. Neighbor's given, underline common noun. And parrots is also common noun. Okay, these you can underline. Next we come to abstract noun. So abstract nouns are usually the names of qualities or feelings, okay, or ideas you cannot touch. If I say sweetness, sweetness you cannot see or touch, you can only feel. Happiness, sadness, you can only feel. So they are all abstract nouns which cannot be seen or touched. So next page, complete these sentences with abstract noun forms of the words in color. Check with your teacher or dictionary for the correct spelling. Okay, so let's see this one. B1. First one is, pulpit is Pankaj is so kind to his pets. They love him for his kindness. Plants grow well in our garden. The sunlight helps their growth. So second one is growth. G-R-O-W-T-H. Third, those soldiers were brave. The newspapers wrote about their bravery. This is all abstract noun. B-R-A-V-E-R-Y. Bravery. Those soldiers, fourth one, Okay. Third one is bravery. Fourth one, Kumar is very honest. He told the teacher that he did not complete his homework. The teacher liked his honesty. H-O-M-E-S-T-Y. Honesty. We laugh loudly when we watch cartoons on television. Our laughter wakes up grandfather. Laughter. L-A-U-G-H-T-E-R. So, second growth, third bravery, fourth honesty, and fifth one is laughter. Next is collective noun. So, children, collective noun is that when we talk about a group of people or things, or group of people or things, we talk, it's of the same kind. That is known as collective noun. Okay, if I say flower, flower can be flower. If I say a bouquet of flower, so you know that there is not one flower, there are many flowers. So, bouquet is the collective noun. Okay, if I say a bunch of grapes, so a bunch of grapes doesn't mean only one grape, there will be many grapes together. So, bunch is also collective noun. Okay, if I say class of students, so class means not only one student, class means many students are there. If I say library, so library does not have only one book, library has many books, so library is also a collective noun. Okay, so here circle the collective noun in these sentences. First one, the army crossed a mighty range of mountains in the north. So army means many soldiers, collective noun. Range means many mountains together, so range is also collective noun. Please put away that pile of clothes on your bed. So you will circle pile. Okay, second, pile. This you can circle. Pile means many clothes. Just put one above the other, that is pile. Our school has a large network of computers. So network you can circle. Fourth, there is a fleet of taxis parked outside the hotel. So, fleet you can underline. We bought a bunch of bananas at the fruit shop. Bunch you can underline. Sixth, they saw a large herd of elephants bathing in the river. Herd. Pile, network, fleet, bunch, herd. These are all collective nouns. Next is words in use. Replace the words in color in these sentences with the words from the box. So some words are given in the box. Effort, wished, return, saw, look after, protect. We will use these words and we will replace it with the word which is in red in color. Okay? So first one is, as Noah walked along the shore, he spotted something in the distance. So spotted means what? To see. So from the box we will take the word saw. I'll grab this. So first one is saw. Spotted means saw. So what you will do, you will just cut the word spotted and just above it you write saw. Noah put the wheel on his full cart with a lot of difficulty. So in place of difficulty, we can write effort. Effort. Noah wanted to save the baby whale. Save, you can write protect. Protect. Noah said he would take great care of the whale. Take great care of means look after. Look after. Fifth, Noah's father said that the whale should go back to its family in the sea. Go back, you can write return. Return. Noah hoped to see the storm whale again. So in place of hoped, we can write wish. First one is saw, second effort, third protect, fourth look after, fifth it's waste. Okay. Next is compound words. Student, compound words means when we use two words, we combine it and form single word. That is known as compound word. If I take the word news and if I add paper, so see, news is one word, paper is another word, and if I combine both, it will become newspaper. A new word will form, no? So this is, newspaper is a compound word, okay? Similarly, if I take motor, motor is one word, boat is another word, and if I combine it, it becomes motorboat. It is new word, which is different from these two words. So this is compound word, okay? This is compound word. So when we join two or more words to form a new word, that is known as compound words. So let's see here. B1, match the words in A with the words in B to form compound words. Write them in C. So let's see this one. So first is motor. So you will add it with boat, F1, and it becomes motor boat. Motor. Second, sea, and you add it with shell, it becomes seashell. S-E-A-S-H-E-L-L, seashell. Note plus book, notebook. N-O-T-E-B-O-O-K, notebook. Fourth, up plus stairs, upstairs. U-P-S-T-A-I-R-S, upstairs. Cup plus boat, cupboard. C-U-P-B-O-A-R-D. These write correct spelling, cupboard, okay? Table plus spoon, tablespoon. Table, spoon. T-A-B-L-E-S-P-O-O-N. Tablespoon. So first is motorboat, second seashell, third notebook, fourth upstairs, fifth cupboard, and sixth tablespoon. Okay, so these are all compound words. Next is listening. Listen to some interesting facts about blue whales, then choose the correct words and phrases to complete these sentences. Blue whales are the dash animals that live on earth. So you tick mark on B1, largest. I will do it here. First, B, largest. Second, depending on the season, blue whales move from one place to another. So you mark on A1. To look for food and a warm climate. To look for food and a warm climate. This you can take. Third one, blue whales eat tiny ocean creatures called krill. C1, okay? Krill. Fourth, they are also the loudest animals on the planet. A1. Loudest. And fifth one, the hunting of blue whales by human has, you mark on C1, decreased their population with time. Decreased. Decreased means to lower. Decreased their population with time. So this you can mark. First B, second A, third C, fourth A, fifth C. Okay, in writing part we can leave, no problem. So with this we finish the exercise. exercise part, children, of chapter 1, and I want you all to complete the exercises whatever I have taught today and learn all the exercises properly, because it will come in your exam. Thank you.